This is going to be the first video in a series of two videos in which we will talk about the theory of the subspace topology. Let's start with the definition. We have a topological space Xt and a subset of X, Y, and we want to define a topology in this subspace. So for this, we will use the topology that we already have in X, and what we will do is graph all the elements in the X topology and intersect them with Y. So this new topology will be the subspace topology in Y. Usually when you read Y as subspace of X, we immediately are talking about Y with the subspace topology. Essentially, what we are doing is, let's say this is our set X, and this is the subset Y. So to convert the subset into a subspace, we want to define a topology. Now we already have a topology T defined on X, so we know that there are some sets in the space that we call open sets. And the idea is to define this new topology with the intersections of these blue sets with our set Y. So for example, I can take this element here. This is going to be one of the elements in tau sub Y. I could take, for example, this other one, the intersection of this big element with my set gives me this, but there are many others. So I have this other one, there are probably a few more that I'm missing, but you get the idea. The idea is graph every element you have in your original topology and intersect it with your subset. Now you have a new topology, and that topology will make Y a subspace of X. Before jumping into the examples, let's see a few properties. These are two properties, very simple. Suppose that Y is an open subset of X. Being open in X means that Y is an element of the X topology. Let's call it like this, tau X, the same here. And I graph U, a subset of Y that's open in Y. So open in Y means that U is a subset of the subspace topology in Y. So U is in tau Y. If we have this, then U is also open in X. This is not complicated, and what's important here is that Y is open in X. This obviously doesn't always happen, but what happens is, because U is open in Y, then we know that there exists some set B in the X topology such that U is equal to Y intersection B. This is direct from the definition. An element belongs to the Y topology if it can be written as Y intersection some other element in the X topology. So in this case, this U would be the B element I said that existed. Now, B, I said, is an element in the X topology, and also from our hypothesis, we know that Y is also in the X topology. So we have two elements in the X topology, their intersection is also going to be in the X topology. But the intersection, I just said it was U. So U is an element in the X topology. Very simple. Now let's see another property, and this one could be very useful. Let's suppose we have again X, tau X, a topological space, and suppose that it's generated by a basis Bx. Well, then the set By of intersections of Y with B, elements of the basis of X, this is a basis for the subspace topology in Y. Let's use this second result in an example with a real line. take x to be the real numbers with the standard topology, y to be 0, 1. So we know that the standard topology is generated by open intervals. And so we ask, okay, what is now the subspace topology for this set Y? From this result, we know that it's going to be the topology generated by intersections of the 0, 1, our set, with open intervals. So take an open interval, like that, AB, and we will consider AB intersection Y. To see what this is, let's make a drawing. Y is the 0, 1. And AB is just any interval in the real line. So one thing that could happen is that AB could be an interval here. In this case, AB intersection 0, 1 is AB. So this intersection is giving me the same element. We're obviously going to have different cases. The first one then is AB, and this will happen if A and B are between 0 and 1, so 0 less than A, and all this less than 1. What would happen now if our interval was like this? If A was smaller to 0, but B between 0 and 1? Well, in this case, the intersection of this interval with the 0, 1 would be giving us the 0 closed and open in B. So this happens if 0 is less than B, less than 1, and obviously A smaller than 0. We could also be in a situation like this. And now the intersection would be the set A, 1, like before. Now this happens if A is the only element between 0 and 1. And let me add here that A was smaller to 0. Is this everything, or do we have more examples? If my interval was somewhere here, the intersection with the 0, 1 is empty. And what if my interval was like this? Well, then this interval is so big that the intersection with the 0, 1 is the 0, 1 itself. So it's giving me my whole set. And I'll just write here otherwise. So what this is telling us is that these intersections have these forms. And we know that the intersections are what form the topology. So for example, we could have the interval 0, 1 half, and this interval is open in the 0, 1. But this interval was not open in the real line. Why is it open in the 0, 1? Well, very simple. 0, 1 half is the 0, 1 intersection, the, for example, minus 1, 1 half. The same would happen with intervals like, for example, 1 half, 1. This one can be written as 0, 1, intersection, 1 half, 2. And so they are open in the 0, 1 because these two sets are open in the real line. So the intersection of the 0, 1 with sets that are open in the real line gives us sets that are open in the 0, 1. So this example shows us that the subspace topology can be a bit more complicated than the usual topology we had in our original space. So in the next video, we're going to see how this can complicate even further when considering different topologies in a subspace. Remember that if you want to support the channel, you have different ways to do so. All the links are in the description of the video. You can either leave small donations on Ko-fi, join us on Patreon, buy books on Amazon, or buy t-shirts in our store.